All right, Eliot Spitzer's second coming? All right, let me rephrase that. After hooking up with hookers, can New York's former governor once again hook up with voters? Stranger things have happened, Shivani Joshi.
They certainly have. We are a nation that loves our comebacks. We forgive the transgressions of Clinton and his cigars and limos. We want to see Britney survive. We forgive Hugh Grant after he did God knows what with who knows what. I mean, listen.
Did Hugh Grant? Yeah, I know. That was out of the blue.
All right. Let's not go back there. Okay. But absolutely, this is a country that loves comebacks, and why not? And that would be a great one. Eliot Spitzer, back in office.
Jonathan, she's right. Stranger things have happened. We can't rule anyone's career out. But what do you make of that? For those who are just saying he wants back in, we're told, to a political career, not necessarily the governor's mansion, but maybe a step toward it, a state senator, something like that.
Well, Leah, I got to say, I'm surprised. And as somebody who, you know, works in Wall Street and financial circles, it was never his private life that bothered me. I mean, honestly, who among us hasn't solicited a couple prostitutes here and there? It was his work in the AG's office. That's a joke. That it was his work in the AG's office. I mean, this was a guy who bullied
Robbie,
witnesses.
That's a Fox News alert.
He sued Ken Lango over nothing.
Honig solicited prostitutes.
No. Listen, Spitzer ran the AG's office like a mob squad. It's not his private life I think it should be embarrassed about. It's his public life. And that's why I hope he stays in the private sector.
Well, you know, I was thinking, Mike Papantonio, I mean, people like Ken Langone who are happy to see that this guy went, the private life stuff notwithstanding, might worry again if he tries to reassert himself, right?
I don't think so. Look, everything's possible in politics and culture. You've got the hitman, the RNC hitman, Tom DeLay, being prosecuted right now for money laundering down in Texas. He's doing the tango on ABC's Dancing with the Stars. You've got restroom Republican Larry Craig. He's moved from the men's bathroom stall into a leadership position with the GOP. Mark Stanford, John Ensign,
Newt Gingrich. Where is he in a leadership position with the GOP?
Well, Watch him in the next couple of weeks. He's already started this move back into legitimacy, just like David Vitter did. He was on the John list of the D.C. madam out of Washington, D.C. Now they listen
so
to John,
left
to
all
David Vitter.
The Democrats. But you're right, does that mean Democrats, Republicans? And Shabani's right.
Well,
so this idea that you can come back. But, Lizzie, I mean, there are some things that take much longer to come back from, aren't they?
Yeah, and I'm wondering when William Jefferson is going to throw his hat in the ring to run to, you know, for president after he put that money in the freezer. But, you know, I'm not so sure I'm liking this thing about, you know, the American comeback. This is a man who, as you noted, broke the law. You know, he was a man who cracked down on prostitution rings, was found to be with a prostitute, and the announcement came during a family planning conference, a speech he was giving. So, you know, and also Jonathan's right. He is an intemperate, self-anointed crusader who tended to indict companies in the press without due process of the law. And, you know, he threatened to indict AIG if they didn't toss Hank Greenberg, the board didn't toss him.
He should have.
And he threatened Goldman head John Whitehead when he wrote an editorial critical of him.
Fox News alert that he might have done the same thing.
That he might have done what?
The same thing.
I don't know what's the same
thing.
He
didn't. We're not kidding. He didn't. He didn't.
No, Jonathan was. No, I don't think Jonathan was thinking that at all.
Please, he's too classy. But Shabani, I mean, stranger things have happened, like you said.
Yep.
But to the fear that you know, say what you will of his private life, like Honig said, this is a guy who was first on Wall Street and malfeasance and abusing problems, and we'll take this to the end, guys. And now, you know, he could be back.
Yeah, and we have a short-term memory as a public. You joked about Hugh Grant. Exactly, that's the point. We forget the transgressions of people when we have a few months that separate
us. He's a good actor.
But wait a second.
Robert Downey Jr. Is a good actor.
There is an opportunity and a weakness that's going on right now in government, in Albany in particular. As a result, there is an opportunity for him to resurrect himself as a superhero.
You're overstating Spitzer's track record on Wall Street. He cracked down on analysts, putting way too much emphasis on analysts as being smart market watchdogs and callers of stocks. Big deal. That, you know, analysts basically are corporate shills or fed information from investor relations departments and write the reports up.
Right.
So what that Spitzer
Look,
cracked
it's
down
not
on that.
Be a moral
he really didn't
issue.
Crack
it's
down on the real fraud going on down on Wall Street.
Keeps him out of politics. That's
what,
the truth.
Mike, what are you
it's
saying?
Not going to be a moral issue. It's not going to be a moral issue that keeps him out of politics. Look, think about this. John Ensign was head of the Promise Keepers. It's an all-male Christian prayer group while he was making whoopee there on C Street there in Washington, D.C.
I love that you only mention Republicans. It's like Democrats never had this problem.
You know why? Because it's about 10 to 1 Republicans to Democrats.
10 to 1?
The Republicans have this moral committee. They have the moral committee, the Ensign, the Stanford, the Craig, the Vitter. It's the morals committee.
You know, Mike, you make stuff up.
Raised hell. Raised hell.
You make stuff up, Mike.
Clinton got into trouble, and now
they
live lives look like Marquis de Sade, and it's okay with the Republican leadership.
All right, Jonathan.
That's the truth. I mean, there's no way to dress it up.
And you know what? Let's take a look at Spitzer's record. I mean, any accomplishments he's had have always been in the political sphere. He's power hungry. He's never made any money in the economic sphere. What's he doing now? He's working at his dad's real estate firm. So,
he
might have
from
credentials
money, right?
as a crusader.
I mean, he's not, when you say it, isn't it
from,
he comes
from a lot of money.
Jonathan,
from a lot
you know
of money.
What Spitzer
and he shook down a lot of big firms, Neil, for a lot of money over
non-crimes. Shook him down. Well, you know what? Had he had his way, had he been able to do what he should have done, you wouldn't have had the AIG problem. You wouldn't have had the Goldman Sachs problem.
I think
problem.
That's
overstating.
But
he was a little busy, wasn't he, Mr. Schmitty Pants?
Because he was trying to do what
I'll give you the final word, but you made me think of something. Dr. Kevorkian.
Well,
he's on the show tomorrow. We're inviting Mike back to try something. Could call me silly.
Make him the market watch.
Dr. Jack Kevorkian tomorrow. Mike pops in for us.